for all being here. Oh man, this is something else. All right. Sorry about that. Hey, here, come on for the audience. Here, you take this, kid. All right. Yeah, all right, all right. Let's see if I hear me. All right. All right. So nice to have y'all here tonight. Yes, I'm glad we got our second season now. Yeah, definitely. Awesome. Glad to hear you at home. Got some good people here tonight. I got one of the sons of Zebedee. That's right. That's right. Made the big fishing catch. We'll talk about him later. But in the meantime, have you heard about Caesar Augustus? Yeah, it's pretty bad. He's gotten so powerful now that he's actually made a decree against the heat. Yeah, I got that one. That was a good one. That was a good one. All right. All right. Well, let's. Whoa. Here, lucky person in the audience caught that. You get that over there. There you go. All right. Well, now it's time for our guest, Mr. James Zebedee. Come on, welcome, Mr. James
Zebedee. Welcome. I just want to welcome you.
It's great to be here. It's great.
I just want to welcome you to this show tonight. And we just want to welcome you. We just hope you feel welcome.
It's good. It's good to be here.
We just hope you feel welcome. Have a seat right here.
I'm welcome.
Just, you have a seat. And you just, hey, welcome. Welcome to our show today.
Oh, that was great. I love the crowd.
Welcome, Mr. Zebedee right here. Welcome. We just want you to feel welcome here. You are welcome to be here whenever you want.
I can't get enough of this crowd, though.
It's amazing. It is electric.
It's good to be here.
It's great to have you here.
Yeah, I love being here.
It's great to have you here.
I can't. Okay, one more time.
All right. Well, we want to welcome Mr. James Zebedee right here tonight. As long as he feels welcome. I'm excited to have you on. I'm excited to be here.
Big fan. Watch all the time.
Well, let me tell you, I'm a big fan, and coffee's strong tonight.
Just how I like it.
Well, I just happen to have some people in the audience here who are big fans of yours. I myself am a big fan. I like to fish, too. That's why I was so surprised when I heard about the catch that you had out on the Sea of Galilee a couple days ago.
Yeah, and I can't be modest here. Big catch is below par what I would say. It was a huge catch. Huge.
Hey, absolutely right.
I wish I could take all the credit. It was my brother with me. But hold on. 1 second. I believe I brought it with me. Hold on. Let's go.
Oh, what has he got here for us?
Right here.
Oh my God.
Right here.
This is the net?
This is the net. Go ahead. Look at that. Oh my God.
This is the net.
That's right.
The net that he used. It still smells like fish.
Yeah, it always does.
These things are heavy.
Yeah.
A lot of people, they don't understand how
heavy these things are.
Yeah.
But they're heavy.
Yeah.
I mean,
I tell you what, you get a workout when you're out there.
You're out there all day with these things.
Oh yeah.
12, 15 days.
Sometimes more at night.
That is something else.
Yep.
Now, I know your brother elected to come on today. No.
Prior engagement, also a little camera shy, so we can't blame him too much.
Okay, so any rumors about him being, not a fan of the show or having harboring bad feelings? No, that's good. That's good to hear. That's good to hear.
Both great big fans.
That's good to hear. We're so sorry he couldn't make it. But man, that is a heavy net. I tell you what, I'm going to lay this right down here.
Yeah, don't you lose that.
We're not going to lose that. Okay, we're not going to lose that. We're back after the show. We're going to lose that. And if you want, I believe after the show, folks, we might let you come up here and he will give you a piece of, not the actual net, but a piece of a net that was used in a fishing story. Folks, there has been rumors, I don't know, this may not be true. Some people were hoping that maybe you would give them a piece of not the net, but a net that you had fished with at one time, or at least somebody had fished with on a boat.
Yeah.
Sometime. That wouldn't be in store for today, would it?
No, not at all. Don't have an extra net, don't got the money. That's a lie, what you...
But, All right.
They spread around, I tell you what.
Yeah. Now tell me, what is it like being out there on the open sea? Jesus, who's the Roman government, it does not like...
There's nothing I'm going to go...
No, he's not friends with the Roman government. He's not. No, so he comes up and asks you to come with him. Okay, what went through your mind when you, be in mind that this was right after the magnificent world record catch that he was speaking about earlier.
Yeah.
Right after that. You know, your dad, you, your brother owned it. You know, I always buy my fishing supplies from them. Mm. I get their catalog every fall.
That's good.
It's a great business you got. Why would you at this time, after such a world record landmark catch, this would have put you guys on the map even more, possibly got you into Egypt with your catalog. Why now are you choosing to walk away from the family business?
Okay, I tell you what, it's something hard to describe. It just, he came out there and he told us to throw our nets. We was having this horrible luck, and for some strange reason we was just throwing our nets to one side all that day. You might want to get that.
Excuse me, folks.
You know, one of those days at work where, you know, it's just, you wake up, you think you're gonna have a good day.
We've all had those, right? Yes, we all have.
Yeah,
we've all had them.
Yes, I. You know, it started waking up like that, and then you know, I took my net and I threw it over to another side, and that's because Jesus. Well, let me explain. You know, the reason we did that. Jesus stood on the banks and told, you know, me and my brother throw it on the other side, and we did. It was so heavy we couldn't even get it up in the boat. I mean, this is it was huge, and it just, you know, you get excited because you got this. So, you know, we're thinking, oh, record catch for the day. This, you know, this is gonna be big, you know. So we get back. Little did we know we was gonna throw down our nets that day and start trailing around with Jesus. And you might want to ask yourself, you're like, why would somebody do that? And you say, you know, you just get a feeling over you, you know. You just, something just fills you up. And suddenly you want to go out to people and you want to say, you know, you want to go to homeless people and you want to have a packed lunch for them and you want to give it to them and you want to say, here, I get it now. I get it. And I just haven't felt this good in a long, long time.
As a matter of fact,
Nazzy Town.
Didn't Jesus, the guy who called you out from the fishing, was not he from Nazareth? You knew that question had to come. I had to ask you that.
I forget sometimes to switch up the scenes.
I had to ask you that question. I had to ask you that. Yeah, they sure do. Now tell me, what is it like being out there on the open sea? It was great.
I'm so glad.
Yes, I'm so glad. Hey, folks, you'll get a hand for Zebedee's son right here. A hand for Mr. James Zebedee.
Could you play the music one more time for me?
Hey, absolutely. And we'll have to get some. We'll have to get that fishing trip started sometime.
Hey,
me and you.
Me and you.
And
me.
Yes.
Yes.
We love. Yes. Yes. Don't forget the net. Yeah.
Good.
And you can. Hey, you get them to get you another cup of coffee on your way out. Get that song down. All right.